and welcome to this very special interview. Joining me today is Mahendra Jaju, who's the Chief Investment Officer Fixed Income at Mirae Asset, one of India's fastest growing mutual fund houses. Thanks very much, Mahendra, for joining me in these difficult times. Mahendra, in the Indian context, you know, a banking product, a savings account, FD has been traditionally a very preferred option for, most people to do their savings. But currently they're seeing sharp rate cuts there as well. And the returns are, next to nothing on a post-tax basis. Do debt funds, according to you, provide a good alternative to banking products?
I think not only today, but at all times, the debt mutual funds have generally performed better than bank FD. There is still a lot of gap in terms of the understanding of the debt mutual funds by the investor community in general. Even when the interest rates were high, in the following period, the debt mutual funds have done better. So if you look at the current situation where the savings account are giving you something like 2.5%, where a short-term fund is likely or has already given in the last 3 years, let's say something like 7.5-8%. You go back to 2018 when the interest rates were high, and since then the bank FD rates have come down. But in that period, even a gilt fund has given a double-digit return. Most of the banking and PSU debt funds have given double-digit return. So if the bank FD rate is high, and if then the rates come down, then the capital gain benefit that accrues to the debt mutual funds also helps outperform the bank FDs. And we are not even talking about the huge tax advantage that exists when you invest in a debt mutual fund for a period of 3 years. Obviously, there is a range of types of funds in the debt space, starting from liquid fund to all the way up to the bond funds. So it is not that every debt fund will outperform the bank FD at all times. So there are periods when, suppose there is a sudden disruption in the market. During those brief periods, the debt mutual fund, one can present an Excel sheet or a good PPT saying, look, bank FDs are doing better. But that's not the right way to look at it. As much as today is not the day to tell anyone that, look, your equity market returns for last 3 years are negative, so bank FDs do better than equities. That's not the way. So the investor has to choose the right product. The only thing that goes wrong is if investors opt for an aggressive credit fund, because whenever the economic environment becomes challenging, the credit space suffers. So in lending, one of the fundamental rule is that if you lend money to someone and he doesn't pay you back on time, then all your return calculations are invalid. So I think if the investors choose the right product with the correct risk appetite, then the bank FDs have no chance to compete against the debt mutual funds.
It's been a pleasure talking to you, Mahendra Jaju. Thank you very much and wish you all the very best. You hope you continue to serve Indian investors equally well in the future as well. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Vivek. Thank you so much for inviting and thank you so much once again.
Absolutely. Thank you very much, Mahendra.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.